Hi, welcome to type 2 diabetes number 9. Today I'll tell you why patients with type 2 diabetes feel like urinating all the time, and they have sweet urine, and they feel thirsty all the time. Now, I told you before that doctors used to taste the urine of patients a long time ago to see if they had diabetes. And some of you wanted to know at what point the glucose will start to appear in the urine. So today I'll just explain to you everything so you will understand it clearly. Now, for some of you that have been following this channel, you already know that when you eat, especially a lot of carbs, your blood glucose goes up, and this glucose gets into your beta cells of the pancreas and forces them to release insulin. Now, there are other ways to release insulin, but this is the most important one. Then this insulin gets attached to different cells, especially muscle cells and fat cells, and tell the cells to bring the transporters of glucose to the membrane so that this glucose can get into the cells. And inside the cells, they can be used for energy. They can be stored as glycogen, or they can be stored as fat. But what you might not know is that this blood, including the glucose in it, has to pass through the best filter in the world 20 to 25 times a day. Yeah, your kidneys are the best filters in the world. Now, the best machines made to try to replace your kidneys, they look like that. And they cannot even do 10% of the job your kidneys can do. Now, this is how your kidneys work. Inside your kidneys, the small ones that you have, there are about 1 million filters in each side. They look like this. Well, it's not straight like this, it goes. Maybe I'll put a picture there. And the way they filter everything, they don't just choose the waste products and throw them into urine. No, they throw everything into this tube to go to the toilet. Well, there are some things in between, like your bladder, but the destination is the same, the toilet, except some cells and maybe big molecules like protein. But along the way, everything that is important to the body will be taken back to the body. So at the end, only some water and some waste products will get to the toilet. Now, I might ask you, do you think glucose is important to the body? Well, I hope you said yes, because you are buying glucose. The body doesn't make glucose from air. You are buying glucose. So you don't want to be wasting top dollars buying food to just realize that your kidneys are throwing all of them in the toilet. So glucose is very, very important. And all of it will be taken back to your body. So in normal situation, you can't find glucose in the urine because it's important. It's on the VIP list. Every time it passes here, these transporters will take them back. They're called sodium glucose link transporter or co-transporters. However, if your blood sugar is really high, more than 180, there are not enough transporters to take all of them back to your body. So some of this glucose will be going to the urine. So when you have sugar in your urine, your blood sugar is definitely high, unless you have some other conditions. Now, the glucose does not go alone. When the glucose comes back with water. When it goes to the toilet, it also goes with water. These things do not leave by themselves, you know, in your body. Just they leave with water. So when all this extra glucose is coming to the toilet, it drags water with it. That's why if your blood sugar is too high, you will urinate all the time because the extra glucose is coming and it brings water with it. Now, when you lose water, you feel thirsty. You feel like drinking all the time. Then it goes like this. If your blood sugar is high, there are not enough transporters to take all of them back. Some of them will go to urine and it brings water with it. then you feel thirsty, you drink water. But if you drink too much, then you will go to the toilet because you're drinking all the time. So it becomes a cycle. But if you want to stop this cycle, you need to reduce your blood sugar. There's no other way to stop the cycle unless you reduce your blood sugar. Now, how you reduce your blood sugar, that, you know, we have some videos on that and more will come. Now, there are other things like, you know, feeling hungry and losing weight and maybe, you know, problems with your eyes, your feet, your, you know, wherever the complication is. But we'll do that later. Now, there's one medication that works here. Maybe if you want to know about it, I'll make a video on it. But these medications will block these transporters, so glucose will go to urine. And when you're taking those medications, know that you're buying food, and half of it is going to... If you have any questions, you can write them here. I will try to answer all of them. And if it's a good one, I'll make a video about it. So I have a lot of them on the list, but you know, we just cover them one by one. Make sure you like this video if you liked it, and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos. So have a blessed week. Bye. Now, one more thing. For those of you that do not know that you are fearfully and wonderfully made, you probably don't know about kidneys. This is a piece of work. Bye.